You know I gotta tell you what you gotta know. Tell you what you gotta know. You know I gotta tell you what you gotta know. Tell you what you gotta know.
Hey kids, it's me, Callie from the Valley, and I'm like here to tell you like what you gotta know. Today, we're like talking about how like God can turn grody situations into good ones. So every time today somebody asks you what you gotta know, you tell them. God can use the bad for good. Bad things happen to all of us. You can like probably relate to these. Like when your bangs just won't get high enough, or like when you're at the mall and the mall cop is like, you can't roller skate in here and you have to like walk. Or like when your cassette tapes get like totally jammed in your Walkman and you can't listen to your favorite song. You know what I mean, right? Yeah, well, whatever. Those are like totally awful situations. But the point is, God can like turn any bad situation into good. He can like turn the beat. I mean, he can like turn things around for you. So every time today somebody asks you what you gotta know, you tell them. God can use the bad for good. And that is what you gotta know. I'm Callie from the Valley saying TTYL. Okay, like, what you gotta know? God can use the bad for good.
Hey guys, Pastor Steve here, and I'm here with today's Bible story. Today's story is found in Genesis chapter 50, and it's about a guy who definitely had a tough life. His name was Joseph. You see, Joseph was the favorite son of his father, Jacob, and his older brothers did not like that. Joseph had 10 older brothers and one younger brother, and his 10 older brothers did not appreciate the fact that Joseph was their father's favorite son. In fact, Joseph's brothers became so angry at him that they ended up selling him to some traders that were passing by. They sold him into slavery. Joseph went through a lot over the next few years. He ended up being accused of something that he didn't do, which resulted in him going to prison. While he was in prison, he interpreted some dreams, only to be later forgotten and left in prison. To make a long story short, God used Joseph in a powerful way, and he ended up being placed as second in command of the entire country of Egypt. Joseph ended up reconnecting with his brothers, and later on, he reconnected with his father, and then they came and lived with him in Egypt. Eventually, their father died, and after he was buried, Joseph's brothers began to get very, very worried. They were convinced that Joseph was still mad at them for everything that they had done to him when he was young. They believed that Joseph was going to try to take revenge on them for selling him into slavery and mistreating him. The brothers told Joseph, "Please forgive us for what we did to you. We will be your slaves if you want. Just don't kill us." Joseph cried when he heard this. He was so sad that they couldn't see that he was not that kind of person. At that moment, Joseph said something amazing to his brothers. Joseph said, "Do not be afraid of me. Am I God to judge and punish you? As far as I'm concerned, you intended to harm me, but God intended it all for good. He brought me to the high position I have today so I could save the lives of many people." The brothers couldn't believe what they had heard. Not only did Joseph not want to harm them, but Joseph believed that God had actually allowed all of the bad things that happened to him in his life so that God could use them to bring about good for Joseph and his family. That wasn't all. Joseph said to them, "I will take care of you and your children from this day forward." Wow. What an incredible attitude. Joseph believed that God could use even the worst situations in his life to bring about great things for him and his family. That is exactly what God did.
Hey, boys and girls, Pastor Jason here, bringing your Sunday lesson. We're going through the year of the Bible. We're talking about turning it around. We just learned about Joseph and the Bible story and everything he went through. And he went through a lot of bad things. But Joseph was a good guy. I mean, he didn't ask for all that trouble. He didn't ask for all those problems. And sometimes as Christians, we feel the same way. Like, God, I love you. I go to church. I listen to my parents. I do my homework. I do all the right things. But there's still bad things happening to me. Even when you become an adult, you can go to church every Sunday. You can sing your heart out and go to all the Bible studies. But you're still going to have bad things happen to you. And that can be confusing. I mean, look at Joseph's life and a couple of things that happened to him. His brothers hated him. He was sold into slavery. And eventually he was thrown into prison. And that's only a few things that happened to Joseph's life. All these bad things happened to him. But the one thing I love about Joseph that you should want to be as a Christian is he never lost faith in God. That even when his brothers hated him, he never lost his faith that God loved him. Even though he was sold into slavery, never lost his faith that he was free in Jesus. Even though he was put in prison, he never lost faith that God will always deliver him. So boys and girls, let's go over three things that you can do to help you when bad things happen to a good person like you. So the first thing Joseph did in our first point is he realized that bad things happen. Boys and girls, that's just part of life. Nowhere in the Bible will you find it says, you'll never have a problem, everything will be easy. Jesus never said, come to me and all your problems go away, you'll be rich for the rest of your life, you'll never shed another tear. He didn't say that. He said you will have problems. He promised persecution. But even look at Jesus' life. He had to carry that cross and be nailed to it. Even bad things happened to him, even to the perfect person who was good. So boys and girls, we just need to accept that fact that bad things happen. Our second point is, remember, God is in control. Now, boys and girls, if you never lose sight of this one point, it'll help you a lot in life. That even in the chaos, even through all the problems in your life, remember, God is in control. That you're out of control is even in God's control. Now, think about it. God knows the beginning from the end. He knows your future. He knows what tomorrow brings. So maybe you have a hard time in your life. Maybe someone's sick in your family with COVID still. Or maybe your mom and dad lost their job. And you may not see a way out of it. God already has the answer. He's in control of that situation. So no matter what's happening in your life, remember, God is in control. And our third and final point is, God can take the bad and use it for good. Now, God is probably the only person in the universe who can declare this and say this. That even though Joseph had a lot of bad things happen in his life, eventually God turned it all around, made him second in command of Egypt, reunited his family, God took care of the family that was about to happen. God had all this in mind. He knew that no matter what happened, he would have it in control. And Joseph had that too. That, you know, bad things are happening to me, but God can make it into good. So your mom and dad may have lost their job because of COVID or laid off, but God may have a better job waiting for them after this, and he can turn that bad situation to good. That sick person, they may come to Jesus because you get a chance to pray for them. So God can turn all bad things into good things. Finally, boys and girls, we need to remember that Jesus, he endured all this bad for a good thing. He endured the cross, the ridicule, the Pharisees, his friends betraying him. Jesus endured all the bad things for the greatest gift he could give us, and that's salvation. So boys and girls, remember that we need to turn it around, that God can turn it around when bad things happen. So once again, we'll go for our 3 points. Our first one is, bad things happen. Number two, remember God is in control. And number three, God can take the bad and use it for good. All right, boys and girls, I hope this encouraged you. We'll see you next Sunday.